much for this time. Gracias a todos por estar acá nuevamente, por permanecer aquí con nosotros. Tenemos a nuestro dirigente Dave Jaus. Enrique Ramírez tiene el primer turno. Adelante.
Good afternoon, Mr. Jaus. Did you contemplate Cubia for the 7 innings, or did you leave him for his good performance?
Well, he was in his pitch count, and he had just retired the three guys really well in the top of the sixth, and he was plenty strong, and we tip our hat to Lugo for ambushing a first pitch fastball and give him a home run. I didn't expect that to happen, and it's a really good question. It'd be nice to say that after the fact I looked and said, hey, if he's going to hit a home run, might as well bring, you know, Carlton in or Cordero in or somebody like that. But I did believe he was the strongest guy we had for the seventh inning.
La pregunta que hace Enrique era que si contemplaba las 7 entradas de David Kubiak. Él dice que por la forma en que lo vio actuar en el sexto inning, dominando la forma en que lo hizo a los bateadores, pues le dio ese inning extra el séptimo. Lo vio bastante bien para iniciar esa entrada. Y bueno, pues Lugo tuvo un buen contacto con ese cuadrangular que hizo. Pero la idea era que sí, que lanzara esa entrada por como había estado lanzando, sobre todo en ese sexto episodio. Arvin González, he says, can you give us an update on Julio E. Rodriguez and Luis Rengifo?
Yes, I will. Thank you. Julio got jarred again with a foul ball, and out of precaution for him and his career, he did not have any concussion syndromes or symptoms. But we wanted to make sure that, I mean, he's gotten hit like 4 times in the last 5 games. I've gotten to know the umpires really well going out there to talk with them while I was making sure that Julio's okay. And so out of precaution for his career, for the rest of this year, it was better to take him off. We will see tomorrow on how he is. As long as it's not a concussion symptom, as long as it's not a concussion, we'll be ready to go with him. I don't know if he's going to start tomorrow because I can't tell you until I tell them who's going to play. But I don't, you know, our training staff will take care of that. And then Rengifo, if you watch the home run he hit, which was some kind of an at-bat, to have a left-handed hitter drive that ball out of left center field, I haven't seen that too often in this park. That was really good. I think Jorge Mejia telling him to take a pitch and look for a ball in his zone really helped him kind of settle in, which is a compliment to Jorge Mejia, our hitting coach, and Rengifo, Louis. But if you watch the film, and I saw it happen, is he was watching the ball ready to think about a triple, and he didn't touch first base real solidly, got the inside corner. I actually thought they might appeal him hitting the bag. And so we had to take him out. He's just starting. Let's take care of those legs. And I don't know, he's day to day right now, but I would really be surprised if we have him active tomorrow. Just because he's just starting, it's good to give him a couple days of getting sound. Lower half.
Sobre la pregunta que hace de una actualización de los estados de Julio E. Rodríguez y Luis Rengifo, dice que Julio Rodríguez fue golpeado en la receptoría, en la cara, en la careta de cuando estaba de catcher, pero que no es nada grave, simplemente por precaución lo tienen fuera para protegerlo, sobre todo proteger su carrera, pero que no es nada complicado. En el caso de Rengifo, pues el parte oficial dice que presenta rigidez en el tendón de la corva. Él, cuando conectó el jonrón, que no estaba 100% seguro de que era jonrón, dice él que si ven el video pueden ver cómo Luis, cuando se acercaba a la tercera, pues pisó en una esquina de la base, y eso pudo haberle afectado, pudo haberle causado lo que tuvo, pero que su situación es de día a día y que no le sorprendería si mañana estaría otra vez en la alineación. Tenemos una pregunta de David Hernández. Adelante.
Saludos, buenas. Me gustaría saber la valoración del dirigente Dave Jones acerca del desempeño que ha tenido Joe Dunan en esta campaña.
What could you say about Joe Dunan, what he's doing this season?
He's continuing to develop to make himself a major league player and a very impactful player down here. He's plays both sides of the ball. Plays a very, very good third base, and we're going to see him in the future playing first. He was going to go into first later in the game tonight if he doesn't drive that run in. He's even worked out at shortstop. I know that's not always the body type you see, but he's some kind of athlete defensively. And offensively, he's really progressed from the first day of camp that I got down here. He's earned his at-bats and continued to earn his at-bats. And that's a big-time professional leverage at-bat tonight to win a game against a tough pitcher in a tough situation. And I tip my hat to him and all the guys that worked with him, the Marlins. And again, I'm gonna compliment Jorge Mejia again, because it was a really good plan he gave Joe Dunan before going up with bases full and one out in a crucial situation to have us have a walk-off.
Dice que Dunan se ha comportado como si fuera todo un jugador de grandes ligas, bastante profesional, sobre todo en ese turno último, donde enfrentó un momento de mucha presión, de un momento difícil del juego, contra un jugador experimentado, un pitcher, y pudo sacar lo mejor de él para dar ese cuadrangular. Pero sobre todo resalta las cualidades de él como profesional, lo enfocado que está al momento de tomar estos turnos importantes, y dice que por eso pues pudo conseguir ese cuadrangular con las bases llenas para dar la victoria hoy. Jordaniel Abreu, adelante.
Hi Dave, how proud is Dave Jones of the performance of Leones del Escogido pitching guys? What do you expect from the guys at this second half of the season?
Well, thank you. I'm glad you asked that question, because I'd love to tell you that I'm so proud of being in that clubhouse with that team. The clubhouse men, the coaching staff, the trainers, and the players, it is one fun place to be. And I think sometimes you guys see on social media how much fun it is. That's only one-tenth of it, because it's a lot funner than that to be with these guys. And then what they do on the field and with each other in the dugout, they compete every pitch, every play, every inning, no matter if we're down, which happens, it's sometimes 7-0 in the first inning, we compete. Or in extra innings when we have to win in the 12th. Or in the bottom of the ninth, when we've had to battle our butt off in the top of the ninth to keep the lead run off. And so pitching has done a tremendous job, but our defense behind that pitch has been good. And offensively, we give quality at-bats. We haven't had the production we want to have, but we are getting better. So I'm proud.
Dice que se siente muy orgulloso de ese staff de picheo, fue la pregunta que hizo Jordaniel, del staff de picheo, de la defensa que tienen detrás de ellos, de la ofensiva, cómo está funcionando, pero lo que más le gusta de todo el equipo es la manera en que compiten, lo competitivo que son, que se mantienen luchando, no importa la situación del juego, si fue un 7-0 desde el primer inning como sucedió ayer, o si se juegan 12 entradas, o si hay que decidir el juego en la parte baja del noveno. Él está bastante orgulloso de lo que sucede en el equipo, con los coaches, con el staff, con la persona del clubhouse, el personal. Incluso eso se vio en las redes sociales, como un video que se compartió hace unos días por acá por El Escogido. Y se siente bastante contento, bastante orgulloso del equipo que tiene, sobre todo porque es un equipo luchador que no se rinde ante ninguna circunstancia y que trata de sacar la victoria sin importar lo que esté sucediendo. So thank you very much, Mr. Jaws. Enjoy your day. Gracias a todos ustedes por este encuentro y será hasta una nueva oportunidad con ustedes. Feliz resto del día.
¡Vamos, Rojo!